depend on abstractions, not on concretions. This is perhaps the most important principle in object-oriented programming. But why is it so important? Well, let me show you this framework which helps explain why. Here's how it works. If you are operating in this quadrant or this quadrant, then you are following the principle program to interfaces, not to implementations. If you are operating in this quadrant or this quadrant, then you are following the principle of dependency injection. But if you are following both principles, then you end up in this quadrant. And then you are following the principle depend on abstractions, not on concretions. Let me explain. Imagine that we are building a game like the classic game tic-tac-toe, and that we have two classes, one called round and one called player. A round is a game of tic-tac-toe between two players, and an object of type player is a player that plays in a round. So in this diagram, an object of type round will somewhere in its code have two objects of type player. One corresponding to player 1 and one corresponding to player 2. One corresponding to X and one corresponding to O. By the way, notice how we are using the dependency arrow and not the association arrow. The association arrow is a solid line and this is a dashed line. The reason for this is that in this example, it doesn't really matter if player is an attribute of round, is a field or a property of round, or whether it is just a local variable. These principles still hold. A round somehow has references to two players. And the point of this quadrant diagram is to emphasize that there are four distinct ways of setting up the relationship between rounds and players, and that the most flexible way is found down here in this quadrant. So, hence these three arrows, we should always strive towards structuring our systems like this. So this is a quadrant diagram where we have two dimensions, the what dimension and the how dimension. The what dimension regards what the compile time type of a variable is. Is it abstract or is it concrete? And the other dimension regards how objects are assigned to that variable. Is it through instantiation or is it through injection? So if you have a class like round which has a variable of type player, then in the what dimension, we ask what the compile time type of the variable that holds the player is. Is it abstract, as in an interface or an abstract class, or is it concrete, like a class? And in the how dimension, we ask how that player object ended up in the round. Was it round that instantiated the player, or was it sent into the round, injected into the round, by someone else? So if the class round has two variables of the concrete type player, and round itself constructs these players, then we are up here in this quadrant. And I know that this might seem like the simplest solution, but it's actually very, very problematic. Let me explain. What is the problem with instantiating instead of injecting? In short, you have to duplicate the constructor parameters of the instantiated type in the type that instantiates the other type. Here's what I mean. Imagine that the player class has a constructor with two parameters. One is called symbol and is of type string, and the other is called isHuman and is of type bool. So the symbol would of course represent the symbol of a player like X or O or an emoji or whatever symbol that player chooses to play with. And the bool isHuman is used as a flag so that within the player class, we can switch between the player behaving like a human player or the player behaving like a computer player, in the sense that the human player, when it's supposed to make its next move, we wait for user input. But when we have the computer player simply makes a decision on what position to play on its own. Pretty reasonable scenario if you're building a tic-tac-toe game, right? Now then imagine that we want to be able to instantiate rounds that are between two human players, two computer players, and a computer and a human player. In other words, we want to maintain the parameterization of the player class. So that means that we can't hard code the construction of players in round. What I mean is we have to duplicate the constructor parameters of player in round. So notice how the constructor in player here takes a string called symbol and a bool called is human. And the round here also takes a string called symbol and a bool is human. Actually, wait, I messed up again as always. Of course, it shouldn't just say symbol and is human here. It should say P1 symbol and P1 is human, because we also need to know what the symbol of P2, player 2, and the isHuman status of player 2 is. So sorry about that confusion. Let me just quickly fix that. Okay, sorry about that. So of course we have four parameters in the constructor here. We take a string called P1 symbol, a bool called P1 is human, a string called P2 symbol, and a bool called P2 is human. Because of course we need to know the symbol and the human status of both players. So clearly that doesn't seem like a very smart solution. What's worse is that if we keep using instantiation instead of injection, the problem will just grow bigger and bigger and bigger, because if someone uses round and we are not injecting rounds into that class, but rather we are constructing rounds in that class, then we will have to duplicate the parameters of round in that class. So clearly this isn't a viable solution. What's maybe even worse is that if we later down the line need to change the constructor parameters of player, then we will also have to change the constructor parameter of round, because we've duplicated them. But if we move to injection instead of instantiation, then this problem disappears. Now, in the constructor of round, we are not taking the pieces of players so that we can construct players, but we are taking the actual player themselves in the constructor. So notice here how the constructor in round now has two parameters, one called P1 and one called P2, and both are of type player. So instead of instantiating the players within the round says, I expect you to give me players. In order to build a round, you have to have already built players, and you need to give me those players that will participate in this round. And so now, rounds don't care about the constructor parameters of players, because it doesn't care about the construction of players. Much better! We've nipped the complexity in the bud. No more need to duplicate constructor parameters. Okay, but wasn't the idea that we were supposed to move down to this bottom right quadrant? Well, yes. So let's understand what the problem is of using a concretion instead of an abstraction. Remember how we said that the player class takes a boolean called isHuman that we use to determine whether the player should behave as a human or as a computer player. So somewhere within the depths of the player class, there will have to be one or multiple conditionals that look like this. If isHuman, run this algorithm. Else, run this algorithm. Or something to that effect. If it's a human, it asks for user input, but if it's a computer, it just chooses a move on its own. So if you're familiar with the principle replace conditional with polymorphism, then your alarm bells should be going off right now. Clearly, this is a conditional that could be replaced by polymorphism. How would we do that? Well, we would introduce an abstraction. We move from concrete to abstract. We introduce an interface called iPlayer, and then we have two subtypes, one called human and one called computer. And so we will move the algorithm of humanness into the subtype human, and we will move the algorithm of computerness, of computer behavior, into the computer subtype. And of course, for the sake of clarity, these classes should probably be called human player and computer player. But I'm just saving space here. So this is better, right? We no longer need a switch in the player hierarchy. Instead, we are pushing the decision of choosing between the human algorithm and the computer algorithm outwards, so it doesn't have to happen in player, and we don't have to pass the flag down into player. However, we can't push the decision further out than round, if round is the one that instantiates the player. So moving to an abstract compile time type is better than having a concrete compile time type. It's better, but it's not great. Also, notice how round not only depends on iPlayer, the abstraction, but also depend on both human and computer, the concretions, because it is the one that does the construction, the instantiation. So when we move from the top left to the bottom left, we can eliminate the conditional, but we still have this problem of construction, where we have to pass down details further down into the system in order to know what thing to construct, instead of just passing down the thing that we need, so that we don't have to worry about all these details and pass down all these details further down into the system. So when we move from the top left to the top right, when we move from instantiation to injection, we got rid of the duplicated constructor parameters. However, we didn't get rid of the conditionals. And when we move from the top left to the bottom left, when we move from a concretion to an abstraction, we got rid of the conditional, but only at this level of abstraction. We could only push it one level up because we are still duplicating constructor parameters. So this is why we should not stop top, in the top right, or in the bottom left. We should combine both ideas and move towards the bottom right. We should not just program to interfaces instead of implementations. And we should not just use dependency injection instead of instantiating our dependencies. We should do both and get the best of both worlds. We should use abstractions rather than concretions, and we should inject our dependencies instead of instantiating them. This moves us to the bottom right. And now we are essentially following the principle of depending on abstractions rather than concretions, because everything here is dependent on an abstraction. Just a quick note if you want to dig deeper. Grasping the idea of depending on abstractions rather than concretions means that we've grasped the core mechanism of the dependency inversion principle, DIP. So if you want to dig deeper, I would highly recommend that you get both the book Clean Architecture by Robert C. Martin and Agile, Principles, Patterns, and Practices by Robert C. Martin and his son. Those are two seminal books in the world of object-oriented programming. I also highly recommend the more modern book, Dependency Injection, Principles, Practices, and Patterns by Mark Seaman and Stephen Van Dorsen. Links to the books are in the description. They're great. Okay, back to this. So here, the constructor of round takes two parameters of type iPlayer, the abstraction above players, the interface iPlayer. One of the parameters is called P1 and the other is called P2. And then what are some potential players? Again, like over here, we have the human players and the computer players, and both of these are concretions of the abstraction of the interface iPlayer. So now we can replace conditionals with polymorphism, and we don't have to pass in the data that is used to determine what kind of specific player to instantiate, because that can happen much further out in the system. Round no longer needs to duplicate the parameters of players because it doesn't need to construct them. It doesn't need to know anything about players. It doesn't actually even know what kind of players it will be passed at runtime. All it knows is that the players that it necessarily will be passed can be treated as iPlayers. So by using abstractions instead of concretions, and by injecting instead of instantiating our dependencies, we are managing to follow the principle of always depending on abstractions rather than concretions. Which, as you can see, not only makes the code simpler, but way more flexible. Let me know what you think in the comments. Subscribe.